But take us through that, and also what should guide the negotiators.
If you look at it from, let me start from the perspective of Kenya. Kenya negotiating with the US is actually the biggest giant in the world in terms of the size of the economy. And therefore, Kenya negotiating with the US, there's obviously a symmetrical relationship in the sense that the US then has the power, as it's the big boy in the relationship. And therefore, what Kenya needs to do is to be very specific in terms of what it wants to achieve. Let us start from the point that already there's a relationship between Kenya, a trade relationship between Kenya and the US under the AGOA, African Growth Opportunity Act, which basically gives Kenya duty-free, quota-free access in terms of, I think, more than 1,000 items that Kenya can export to the US under the AGOA arrangement. Now, statistics show that Kenya has not really utilized this so much, and we've barely exported, I think, less than 10 items, groups of items to the US under the AGOA arrangement. And so critical for Kenya is to look at why is it that AGOA has not been that helpful? What has been the problem? And are we able to address it under the negotiations with the US? And from where I sit, part of the reason why we've not been able to fully utilize or to a big margin utilize the access under AGOA is because of the production challenges, the supply challenges on the Kenyan side. If you look at the way AGOA was structured, for example, AGOA requires that the rules of origin under AGOA requires that at least 35% value addition of whatever is being exported to the US must have happened in Kenya. And then there's also the requirement in terms of where the raw products or raw materials have been sourced. They must have been sourced either in Kenya or from the US. And these are some of the areas that if our negotiators under the free trade agreement now are able to look at and relax a bit, relax the rules of origin and relax also the requirement on the sourcing of the raw materials, then the net effect of that would be that the agreement would then be able to attract investors who would come invest in Kenya, and also for the reason that they are sure that they have a market, the big market in the US. Number two, Kenya needs to look at the side of what is called trade finance. How can the US assist us in terms of building our capacity to produce and then so that we're able to access the market that they're offering to us? If you take an example of Morocco has signed a similar FTA with the US. And what Morocco did is that Morocco did a study of its market as the supply side, and was able to pick the areas that were very critical for them. And so when they were negotiating the agreement with the US, they put in the provisions that they would require trade finance and technical assistance, especially on the agricultural side. And once this was done, the effect has been that Morocco has been able to export to the US under the FTA more than 50% of what it was doing before. And so these are some of the areas that that if Kenya looks at them very clearly and negotiates the agreement in a way that then gives us advantage in those areas, then we're able to realize the results. You see, if you look at it from the other side, what is the interest of the US in negotiating an agreement with Kenya? Because if you look at the statistics, the US, as I've said, is a very big economy. The US really, strictly speaking, does not need Kenya in terms of trade. The US can stop trading with Kenya today, and I think the effect would actually be negligible, in my view. And so Kenya must also understand why it is important for the US negotiating these agreements, going beyond the written objectives.
Okay, Mr. Church, now we don't have much time, but I want us to talk about the fact that, you know, there's no guarantee that Donald Trump, the U.S. president, will be in office come January 2021. We all know the election slated for 3rd of November this year. The contenders are President Donald Trump and the former Vice President Joe Biden. So is there a need for Kenya's team in Washington to, say, consider informally engaging the Democrats in case the deal is going to be concluded under Biden's leadership?
It is critical, Grace, that Kenya, the Kenyan delegation in Washington, also engages the Democrats in this kind of deal. So if it's to sail through Congress, as you said, there's no guarantee that President Trump is going to be there beyond November this year. And so for the success of this trade deal, it will be very critical that the Kenyan delegation not only engages the Trump administration, but also engages the Democrats, so that in the event that the Trump's administration is not in office beyond November this year, then that of itself does not nullify the benefits that would otherwise accrue to Kenya under the negotiations.
Mm-hmm. Lastly, in under a minute, let's talk about the effects of this agreement, as we like saying to Wanjiku, for instance, here in Kenya, as part of your closing remarks, Mr. Daniel.
Yes, the effects, the likely effects of this agreement to Wanjiku, so to speak, is that when you negotiate a free trade agreement, you are basically opening the borders for goods to come in. And so one of the likely effects is that you'd have more US products in the country. And that can have the effect that then you have, of course, as the consumers, the ultimate consumer, you are exposed to a variety of goods, and therefore perhaps at a cheaper price. But also just in under 5 seconds, the effect of this could also be that, because when you bring competition, then competition is to our local producers. And therefore, unless we negotiate smartly and have provisions that are able to protect our local producers, then the fear normally in such arrangements is that the giants from the US would come and kill our local producers.
Thank you so much, Mr. Daniel Achach, an international trade law expert. Thank you so much for joining us here on Bottom Line Africa. So we're taking a short break here on Bottom Line Africa, but after the break, we'll take you live to the Nakuru High Court.